All right, so this is Google in China. I'm Zach Jambis.
Mike Toomey.
Taylor Chandra.
Chris Padilla.
So Google's executive summary. Google's mission is to organize the world's information and make it universally accessible and useful. So internet censorship affects both publishing and viewing material of the People's Republic of China. According to CNN, internet censorship is more extensive and advanced than that in any other country in the world. The Chinese government blocks website content and monitors individuals' internet access.
But China has hundreds of millions of internet users and a thriving online shopping market, making it impossible for US tech companies to ignore. But jumping back into China presents ethical issues for Google, which has long advocated for a free and open internet.
Google as a company early on made it a goal to provide multinational support to different countries by establishing the same search engine in each respective country.
So Google was founded in September 1998 by Larry Page and Sergey Brin while they were PhD students at Stanford in California. It was actually founded as a subsidiary of Alphabet Inc. and today it has grown into be the most used online service for Americans. It actually handles 70% of all internet searches in the United States.
And from that 70%, all those include internet analytics, cloud computing, advertisement technologies, web apps, browsers, and operating system development.
Economic, political, and cultural dimensions and factors hold numerous effects on Google's international business decisions. In the political realm, globalization poses as an opportunity for the company and can heighten the interest for online advertising. Stable political governments in many major markets encourage expansion. Economically speaking, rapid growth of developing countries give way to new ground, of which Google can capitalize on. This factor, combined with the economic stability of major markets, can provide opportunities of global expansion for Google.
So for cultural sensitivity in Google, you have to really, really place a high importance on this, because certain cultures, what may be acceptable is not acceptable in other cultures. A big difference between Asian and American standards for such qualities could be considered communication, attitude, workplace etiquette, and organizational hierarchy. These things are huge when you're working in different markets. Google has to act one way in the United States and completely different when they're in the Chinese market.
So that brings us to Google's international strategy. So we already know that Google, you know, is utilizing the world's information and trying to make it, and successfully doing so, make it universally accessible and useful. So Sanjay Raman, the Google Apps product manager, further advocates for the global mission, saying that global focus is critical. 65% of interest users around the world are not English. So that brings us into making the world a better place as their primary business goal and utilizing national, international languages, dialects, and such.
So as a start from the beginning, the founders, Larry and Sergey, always thought Google as a non-conventional company. And the reason behind it was because the company's primary goal is to always think in the long term and never think about short-term gains, which leads up to their competitors.
So for their competitors, we know Bing, Yahoo, and there's much, much more. Ask was one at one time. But in doing so, when our findings showed that Google was much more diverse and universally present in, you know, encompassing these different languages, dialects, translation services, and, you know, Yahoo and Bing have failed to do so.
So when it comes to competing with Google for Bing and Yahoo, the main thing is the infrastructure of the search engine itself. Google has just incredibly fast searches, and you can use tools such as advanced search or other things like that to better help get a search. Even like when you Google something and you misspell a word, it'll pull up what you think it means, but then there'll also be something at the top saying like, did you mean to search for this? This is all based on the infrastructure, and for Bing or Yahoo to like actually compete with it, they would have to develop their infrastructure to be much faster and more productive, as well as way more comprehensive, which would take a lot of technical and just laboring hours for them to get done.
This brings us to Google's main international issue with entering China's market, the communism aspect. Certain dimensions can hinder Google's international strategy. For example, not all governments will be as accepting and lenient toward new enterprises. In the case for China, their government continues to remain in control over large firms with a substantial weight toward on censorship toward search engines operating within the country. This posed as a considerable threat toward Google and its global mission.
Okay, so now this brings us to the competitive analysis for Google in China. And with that, it brings us Baidu. Baidu is a Chinese website and search engine that enables individuals to obtain information and find what they need.
Baidu shares a lot of similarities to Google. Some of these similarities include having their own personal map, search engine, messaging application, and the list goes on and on, the similarities. But the biggest difference between Baidu and Google is that Baidu is very censored and Google is not.
So then also, we look here, we have, you know, the graph showing their market share. Now, right here it says Baidu is the second largest market share next to Google in the world, holding 76% market share in China. Now, you can see here, Baidu's revenues actually encompass a clear 86% majority in online marketing services, with others being 15.8%, including Google, etc.
So for this gives us a huge difficulty for Google to enter the market.
A huge reason why Google wanted to enter China's market is due to their large population. In 2019, their population was at 1.43 billion people, and their gross domestic product was worth $13,608 billion US dollars in 2018. This value represents about a fifth of the world economy.
So for the SWOT analysis of Google's situation in China, there really aren't any strengths, to be honest with you. This is the issue they're facing. They're trying to find their strength in the market. Biggest weakness would be Baidu, their competitor, and how Baidu's allowed to go through authorized agencies to sell ads, and Google still has their free market, just like the United States, where you can go up and anyone can sign up and sell ads. Again, this goes back to how we talked about earlier with an international business, you have to accept different cultures, and Google's still adjusting to this. But the reason they put up with this is because of the opportunities. The market share is so big and untapped by so many different platforms that there's just way too much money to be made, and you can't ignore a fifth of the world population, as we said. It's a great opportunity for Google, but it definitely comes with its difficulties. Those difficulties include the threats. Now, China has kicked Google out, or Google has pulled out of China multiple times in the past due to issues of their communist government and their censorship of it, and they don't appreciate how Google is its own thing. They want to own Google in China, and that's not really how Google operates. So it's a little interesting because it's a hard market to penetrate. They definitely have a huge weakness going against Baidu, and there's a lot of threats, but that opportunity is the main thing that keeps Google going back and trying to make it work in China.
Okay, so this brings us towards the end of our presentation, and here we'd like to introduce the market share solutions.
So I think the best way to go about such an acquisition would be extremely sensitively in regards to China's culture, or any country's culture for that matter, and any pre-existing enforcements. If they had simply just pulled out of the market and left it at that, there's a lot that can be said about the company's international approach.
So here are the four solutions that we generated. So starting off, Google's mission statement encompasses the world. It's a global enterprise. They want to encompass having everybody involved, multinational, multi-language, but in accordance with China's ideals, it just doesn't work. So that would be the first, although not the most ideal, but Google could in fact adjust their mission statement. But this brings me to my next proposal, our group's next proposal, and this would be to form a search engine sector specific for China. So then in doing so, they would be able to abide by maybe a little bit more of the Chinese ideal, you know, give them their due in their communist regime, and just kind of a hands-off approach, which kind of goes hand in hand with giving China control over an executive branch. So in doing so with this one, we would give them almost, you know, an upper hand in making decisions just in that subsidiary. And with doing that, we have a hands-off, laissez-faire approach, giving them more control, giving them more leniency. They can use censorships, but then we still have, you know, the upper hand in getting some of that market share and competing with Baidu. And then lastly, another quite, you know, it would be a tough, discussion, because we would actually have to urge Google to go ahead and talk with Baidu and go through the multi, you know, procedure of enacting a merger. But yes, proposing a merger with Baidu would be another feasible yet kind of difficult solution to this problem.
It's just that to have one of the world's largest internet companies not engage with the world's largest internet market, that would just reflect a poor international strategy and their mission statement. It just kind of contradicts. Because I've seen it from some of Google's American rivals, it's not impossible to operate in such a confining government. China stands as one of Apple's largest markets, with Microsoft and Amazon also considerably present.
So in conclusion, we have decided that in coordination with Google's original mission statement, their actions as they built as a company, that they just have to get into China. They promised to give people access to information all throughout the world that they otherwise would not have access to. And in addition to that, we've outlined the benefits of the size of the Chinese market, which makes all the difficulties worth it. If they can make it successful, it'll bring Google to be bigger than they ever could imagine. They're pretty big now, but like, it's impossible to imagine what they can do if they have access to the Chinese market.
Well, thank you for listening. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. My future looks bright.